We're back. Question number two coming up. This is it. Ladies, it's addressed to you. It is also worth $150. Patty and Donald have all the marbles at this point, so let's see what happens. Ladies, your next-door neighbors have invited you and your husband over to their house to watch 4 hours of home movies from their vacation trip to Peoria, Illinois. You'd rather die. Which of the two of you would be better at making up an excuse for not going? Okay? Your neighbors have invited you over to watch 4 hours of home movies from their vacation trip to Peoria, Illinois. You'd rather die. Which of the two of you would be better at making up an excuse for not going? Think about it, ladies. We'll come back and find out momentarily. Gene, what about between you and Betty? Now, who's going to pick up the phone? And?
Well, as I told you earlier, I'm much more forthright.
Uh-huh.
And
It pains
I couldn't
you,
make
it?
Up a lie about the thing at all, you see. Right. So it would have to be Betty who would make the excuses.
She would be better at making up the excuse for not going.
I think so.
You think so? Let's bring her on and find out. Betty, now who would be better at making up an excuse for not going, you or Gene?
I would.
That's what the man said.
That was easy.
Why was that easy, dear?
Oh, because I'm more diplomatic.
That's what he said. You're right again.
Because he's too honest.
You have a share of the pot, dear. Thank you. Donald, how about Patty? What's she going to say?
Bert, remember the time you and Ann and the kids came back from San Diego? And you invited us to dinner.
Yes.
And you had taken your still camera.
Yes.
And we didn't come to dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't it me who got the flu?
I don't remember who called.
It was me.
So you'll say, she'll say, it's you.
It's me.
You're the guy.
I'm the hatchet man.
You're the hatchet man. Let's bring on Patty and find out. Patty?
Mm-hmm.
Who would be better at making up an excuse for not going?
Well, I don't know if he's going to agree with this, but I would say Donald.
That's what he said. You're right.
Rather make up an outrageous excuse to anything than tell the truth through that cute little mustache.
Is that right?
Yeah.
It was a high fever. It really wasn't.
All right, you have a share of the pot, Patty. Thank you. Ward, how about Phyllis? What's she going to say?
Well, I got caught on a previous game with the same kind of question, so I'm going to promptly say it is I who would make up the excuse.
You got caught? You mean that we did this to you once before?
Well, it was a similar question.
Similar question, and you chose her, and you didn't do well.
And I did not do well.
So now you're going to say you're the one.
Yes.
Okay, let's bring on Phyllis and find out. Phyllis, who would be better at making up an excuse for not going?
I would.
Right, Phyllis, but you're wrong. That's not what he said. You can't fool him. That means Patty, Donald, Betty, and Gene share the pot. They split it. We're at halftime. We will change places, fellas, if you will. Step to the rear. Come on out, ladies. While we're changing places, we're going to break away for just a moment. Please come back with us in just a minute, will you? Change places. I have the pretty ladies out here with me. The fellas are all ready to go in the back. Are you not?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Uh-huh. Here we go. This question is worth $150. It's addressed to you, fellas. Don't give me your answer now. Men, we know that your love for each other transcends time and place. But tell us, if you had to choose one of the following, where would you rather make love? Where would you rather make love? Oh, I stumbled right through that one, didn't I? Where would you rather make love? In your own home sweet home or in a new romantic place? Now let me say it again, better.
Please.
We know that your love for each other transcends time and place. But tell us, if you had to choose one of the following, where would you rather make love? In your own home sweet home or in a new romantic place? Think about that, gentlemen, and we'll come back and find out. Betty, what's Jean going to say?
Well, we've always had children around.
Yes.
And so I think he'll say a new romantic place, because somehow at home something always happens.
Yes, right.
You know? Mom, it would be great. Dad. In a hotel room with nobody there. You know?
Okay, he'll say a new romantic place.
I hope so.
Let's bring him on and find out. Gene, Where would you rather make love, in your own home sweet home or in a new romantic place?
Well, I think our bedroom is ready to be redone. And I think we're due for a new romantic place.
That's what the lady said. You're right.
He almost flew it.
No.
Very good.
All right. You're right, Gene. You have a share of the pot. Patty, what's Donald going to say?
Oh, this is hard, Bert.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, because we've moved so many times that home sweet home is a new romantic place. I don't know. Well, it's sort of, our house is sort of new to us now, so maybe that's a romantic place.
Well, but then it would probably qualify as home sweet home, too, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Big trouble.
It's always exciting to mess around elsewhere.
Yeah.
Elsewhere.
Somebody just yelled right on in the second row. Okay, you're going to say, he'll say a new romantic place.
Yeah.
Let's bring him on. Donald, home sweet home or a new romantic place, would you say?
Gee, I'd just like to get lucky this month.
But Donald, the question is, where would you like to get lucky?
Well, since we don't go anywhere, I want to have it at home.
You can come up now, Patty.
Thank you.
That's not what Patty said, Donald. So she'll see you later.
Was she specific? Can I find out the place at least? Maybe a bus goes there, or a train,
that's
or you
not
can get
what
a flight.
She said. Sorry about that.
That's why you haven't gotten lucky. You don't take me anywhere, you fool.
Where do you want to go?
She wants to go to dinner once or something. Sorry, Donald. Phyllis, how about Ward? What's he going to say?
Well, you see, we spend a lot more time in new romantic places than we do at home sweet home.
Yes.
So that makes home sweet home very sweet. And I think that he will say home sweet home.
Okay. Well, there's a little grumbling in the red section. I don't know what they know about it, but they seem to know a lot more than we do. Let's bring on Ward. Ward?
Yes.
Home sweet home or a new romantic place?
Since everybody else is going into a big long spiel before they give you the answer, I'm going to do the same thing for this once. I'm going to say that we travel to so many romantic places constantly that I would prefer home sweet home.
That's what Phyllis said. You're right, sir. Absolutely right. That means Phyllis and Ward, Betty and Jean, split the pot. And at this point, our leaders are still Patty and Donald for the banana section with 2.25. And we'll come back and find out who wins it all in just a moment. Come back, too, please.